Students, good morning to all. Morning. Yeah, welcome you for our chemistry class this morning. Okay. Today we are going to discuss the new topic. We know already in the previous chapters. We discuss about periodic classification. Okay, there we discuss general about the elements, about the general characteristic of those particular elements like that. But this chapter we are going to discuss only related to hydrogen. Okay, and same way. The compounds of a hydrogen also we are going to discuss, and what properties it will exhibit. Okay, those things we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, so first the topic is hydrogen. Okay, first of all, when you think it about a hydrogen. Comes to your mind first, okay? So position in the periodic table, if you take a hydrogen, hydrogen is a first element, okay? Where we see the hydrogen in the periodic table, the hydrogen is placed the first member of our element, okay? At your left side of your periodic table, the first corner, left corner, okay? So above that alkali metal we are going to place. So this is position of a hydrogen, where it is located. But we want to know about the nature of a hydrogen. So for that, let me see about the introduction part of a hydrogen, okay? So usually, we know this hydrogen from the lower classes itself, okay? Because the basic element, we know that hydrogen, where it is present, okay? Hydrogen in the form of compound, water, we are drinking, like that, we are given the explanation, okay? But if you take a hydrogen, it is the smallest element. First is smallest element. Okay, among all, that is whatever may be the element present in the periodic table, if you take comparison with all elements, the hydrogen is very, very, very small. Okay, and if you take a hydrogen, so I write the hydrogen as like this, that is hydrogen, it is a symbol of a hydrogen. You can write like this, okay. We know that this is actually, this is indicating what? The number of protons are a number of electrons. We know that it is an atomic number. So, atomic number. Okay, this is. Okay. Now, if you take atomic number is nothing but what? Number of protons for elements. Okay, you should understand protons, number of protons, and number of electrons you can take or okay, number of protons, okay, or number of electrons, what atomic number, okay, we know already this concept a lot, but anyway, so what number, how many protons, how many electrons in the hydrogen means we should identify, like for that purpose only, just I have given the revision, okay, and if you take the power of okay, one, it is a mass number, okay? So we know that mass number is nothing but number of protons, okay? So protons plus neutrons, protons plus neutrons, how many protons and how many neutrons? Here we are having only one, so it means only one proton possible, neutron is zero. Okay, we know the charge of the protons, neutrons, and the electrons, which is nothing. And if you take the structure of a hydrogen, okay, we will take the structure of hydrogen is like this. Okay, So we have a nucleus. So nucleus present in the center. Okay, this is a nucleus. So in that nucleus, okay, in that nucleus only one proton is present. Only one proton is present. And same way, okay, just we are having one more, that is, this is the first shell, okay, the first shell. The first shell, we are having only one electron, only one electron. So hydrogen has how many proton? One proton and one electron. Now I am indicating the proton present in the center of the nucleus. And the electron, we know that electron is going to revolve around the nucleus in a circular orbit. Okay, in a circular orbit, where the position of the electron only one, number is only one. So only one electron is going to be revolved around the nucleus. So totally, the hydrogen consisting of a one proton and one electron. Okay, one proton and one electron. So it is a very, very simple story. If you take the structure of this hydrogen, okay, so now what happened? This electron is very, very close to the nucleus. This electron is very, very close to the nucleus. Because we know that the first shell K shell, second shell is a L shell. The first K shell, you can put how many electrons? Only two electrons. So hydrogen is a very, very simplest element containing one electron. The K shell is containing what there? Only one electron. Okay, ma? So like that, here what happened? The first shell itself consisting of one electron, it is very, very nearest to the nucleus. Now what happened? So very, very nearest means, okay, it is having high ionization energy. Because if you want to remove this electron, means we have to spend more amount of the energy. Because why more energy we have to spend? Because it is closely, it is firmly attached to the very closely to the nucleus. Okay, so the force of attraction between nucleus and also the electron is high. Like that only we should remember about the ionization energy. Okay, so if you take a hydrogen, it is very, very small. Okay, and because of that, the presentation of one electron, the presentation of one proton. Okay, so just it is the smallest element. Okay, if you take again the nature of the hydrogen, if you take, so the hydrogen is containing one unpaired electron, because we have in hydrogen how many electrons? Only one electron. So one electron, okay, I can represent like this. One electron I can represent like this in the shell. So while I am writing the outer electronic configuration, okay. So the one electron hydrogen, so I can write 1s1, the valence electron, or the electron which is present in the s orbital, only one. So I can denote the electron like this, only one. So this is called a unpaired electron. This is called a unpaired electron. So hydrogen consists of a what? The number of electron is only one, so it means unpaired. If you add two electron, okay, that is called a pair. So suppose this electron is what? Actually, I'm indicating like this one electron. This is called a parallel spin. Parallel spin. The spin in a clockwise direction. Clockwise direction. Okay. So suppose if I am indicating the single electron, okay, like this, means this is understood, it is an unpaired electron having parallel spin and also clockwise rotation, clockwise direction it means, okay. And same way, if you take the another character of a hydrogen, okay. So because of this unpaired electron, hydrogen is more reactive. Hydrogen is what? More reactive. Okay. And also, the hydrogen, if you take, it existing of a diatomic molecule. Hydrogen, it is existing as a diatomic molecule. So what is the meaning of atomic city? We know that. So why I am giving diatomic, it is understood the atomicity of a hydrogen is 2. Okay. So it is a diatomic molecule because H is not existing alone. It existing as H2. It is a meaning diatomic molecule. So yeah, what is called this a diatomic molecule? So how can I know that you are telling that hydrogen is diatomic? From that, how can I understand the diatomic molecule means? You should know about atomicity. Okay, so what is atomicity? So atomicity is nothing but number of atoms. That is number of atoms present in the molecule. Number of atoms present in the molecule. Present in the molecule. Okay. So if I take a molecule, just for example, you are reading about hydrogen. That's why I'm taking a hydrogen. So hydrogen, you can take this is a hydrogen molecule, which it is. Okay. It is not an atom, hydrogen molecule. So this hydrogen molecule is made up of two hydrogen atoms. That's why the atomicity is 2. What is atomicity? Number of atoms present in the molecule. So for making hydrogen molecule, how many hydrogen atoms just we do? The two hydrogen atoms. That's why it is a diatomic molecule. Don't confuse with the diatomic, monoatomic and triatomic molecule. So based on that molecule only, we are going to select whether it is di or mono or triatomic molecule. Okay, and same way, okay, so this is more reactive hydrogen as because of containing untied electron, the hydrogen molecule existing as a diatomic molecule, okay. And how did you know that the occurrence of a hydrogen? Because we know that hydrogen is very, very important. When you are reading organic compound also, just we have completed organic chemistry. Without the hydrogen, we can't write the organic compound. We know that the main thing we should know about a hydrocarbon. So hydrocarbon is not consisting of a carbon and a hydrogen. Those two elements only making a compound. Like for example, your methane, ethane, like that. Okay. So like here also, okay, hydrogen occurs. Okay, occurs in the form of water. In the form of water, we know it is very, very essential things. It is a polar solvent we are using for the drinking purpose. Okay, so this water containing hydrogen. This water is water containing hydrogen. Okay, so occurrence. Next, if you take the carbohydrates, because the carbohydrates also essential because your food is containing water. All those minerals, proteins, vitamins and etc. We are using fats, oils and all. For that, carbohydrates also one of the essential waters. We have to take the nutrients. Carbohydrates can be in the form of water, glucose, fructose, maltose, like whatever may be. But we are taking carbohydrates. Okay, like for example, we know all that is glucose. C6H12O6. Okay, so if I am taking glucose consisting of a hydrogen. So this is a base consisting of a hydrogen, okay. And the same way, if you take protein also. So if I am taking proteins, so proteins, you are not taking as it is. The proteins in the form of a amino acids only we are taking. Okay, amino acids. Okay, just if you take any amino acid, for example, I give you glycine as an amino acid, okay. This amino acid formula, glycine, NH2CH2COOH. Now you take this glycine also containing water, hydrogen. So without hydrogen water, the compound we are not expecting to have. That is, hydrogen is one of the basic elements we require, even though it is smallest. Okay, so that element is very, very important. Okay, now next we are going to see about how that position of a hydrogen in the periodic table. But starting on the class itself, I told you about where it is located. Okay, so as I said that we know already whenever if you are taking the periodic table, the hydrogen it will be what located in the left corner, being the first side of a alkali metal, like that only we are taking the position. Okay. Next, we are going to see the position of a hydrogen. What position? Okay, where this located? So, if you want to discuss about the position of hydrogen, okay. Now I am going to give the comparison. Okay. If I am going to discuss about the position of a hydrogen, the hydrogen is being a smallest element. It is having only one electron in the valence shell. The electronic configuration. If you take the electronic configuration of a hydrogen, 1s1, because how many electron it has? Only one electron. Okay, so this is the electronic configuration of a hydrogen. Now if you take that, it resembles, okay, it resembles the electronic configuration, that is the outer electronic configuration, that is the outer electronic configuration of, okay, alkali metals. Outer electronic configuration of what? Alkali metals. Means I don't know what is the electronic configuration of alkali metals. We know that sodium, lithium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, all those elements are what? Alkali metals. If I take lithium, so we know that lithium is the atomic number is 3. So can you write the electronic configuration? So I can write first 1s electron will be filled. How many electron you can put? 2 electron. 1s2, 2s1. Okay. What is the outer electronic configuration of our lithium? Only this 2s1. So it is nothing but generally we can write ns1. General, because this N, it varies one element to the other element. If, for example, like if I take sodium, okay, the next element 11. So 11 means I can write 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, like 3s1, no? So here the outer electronic configuration is 3s1, okay. But what is the change of between 2s and 3s1? Because only this 2 and 3 only differs. The shells only differs. Okay. So this is 2S shell, this is 3S shell. And when we take sodium, okay, lithium, sodium, potassium, again 4S shell will be included. So like that, there is only changes in the principal quantum number. We know that this is called a principal quantum number. So, we know that what is principal quantum number? If I take all the shells are same, because both are S shell, both are S, 2S, 3S, both are what? S shell only. But how can you differentiate among the S shell? By indicating the number. So, let me start with 1S, 2S, 3S, 4S, 5S, like it is going on. So, this can be differentiated by using of a principal quantum number. So, that's my of difference. Okay, generally, I took this NS1. Generally, what? I took this NS1. Now, you compare this. Okay, compare this. The electronic configuration of a hydrogen is what? 1s1. Electronic configuration of a hydrogen is what? 1s1. Okay. So now the electronic configuration of an alkali metal is what? 1s1. So if you compare this, are both resemblance because the outer electrons only same. So on seeing this two character resemblance, we are think that okay, so this hydrogen can be okay, the properties that is similar to the alkali metals. That is similar to the alkali metal. Now you can see how that the properties or the nature of a hydrogen, it is similar to the alkali metal. What nature it would be similar? Okay. So if you take a hydrogen and the alkali metal compounds, okay. Now if you take okay, the hydrogen and the alkali metals comparison. Okay, now if you take this first one, hydrogen forms, okay, hydrogen forms a Unipositive elements. Nitrogen forms what? Unipositive elements. Forms a unipositive elements. Unipositive element. What is this? Okay. Unipositive element. Because the hydrogen, if I take the hydrogen, I can write as H plus. This is unipositive, monopositive. It is resemblance with the alkali metal also, because alkali metals also we can write like this. That is, we can write Li plus, Na plus, okay, CCM plus, potassium plus, like this only we can write. We are not writing Li as 2 plus, Na as 2 plus, because it is a monovalent, unipositive, monovalent cation. So this is what a unipositive. So this first character, okay, hydrogen forms a unipositive element similar to the alkali metal. So first point is clear. Okay. Now in the same way, the hydrogen also it forms a, okay, so it forms an oxide. So similar to that, it forms an oxides. Similar to that, it forms the oxides. Okay, it forms the sulfides. It forms the sulfides. It forms the halides. Like this, it forms the peroxide. It forms the water peroxide. Okay, so like it forms the oxides, sulfides, halides, and peroxide. Okay, now how can I write all this? Like for example, if I take the hydrogen, okay, so the hydrogen oxides, I can write H2O, hydrogen oxides, I can write the oxides of a hydrogen, okay, I can write the H2O. In a similar way, okay, this is hydrogen forms, okay, this is hydrogen forms oxide. In a similar way, your alkali metal also. Okay, in the similar way, your alkali metal also, alkali metal also, this forms the oxides, sodium oxide, like this, sodium oxides. Okay, if you take sulfides, hydrogen forms the sulfides like H2S, hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen sulfide. Same way, your alkali metal also forms the sulfides, okay, like Na2S, sodium sulfide, like this. Okay, now if you take a hydrogen, it forms a halides, whatever may be the halide you can take, you know that HCl, HBr, HI, like that. In a similar way, your alkali metal also forms a halides in this way. Forms a halides in a Cl. Okay. Same. If you take a peroxide, hydrogen forms a peroxide like this. H2O2, hydrogen peroxide. Like your sodium, the alkali metal forms a peroxide. Na2O, sodium peroxide. Like that, it is going. So, if you take the formation of oxides, sulfides, halides, and peroxides formed by the hydrogen, it is very similar to the alkali metals. Those alkali metals forms the oxygen, sulfur, and sodium sulfide, sodium oxide, sodium chloride, and also sodium peroxide. So like that, it is made. Okay. So if you take that the unipositive elements, the first one, the like hydrogen, it forms water H plus. Similar to alkali metals, Li plus and then Na plus, CCM plus, K plus, like that it is moving. And the same way, it forms. It will be acting as a best reducing agent. Okay. If you take Okay, if you take that, it will be acting as a base. Best reducing agent. Okay, so we know that the hydrogen we can use in the form of a catalyst. Okay, so we know that the hydrogen in the presence of a palladium, platinum also it will be used as a best reducing agent. So those character only we can categorize the elements or what are similar to that of the. Similar to that of the water, the hydrogen and the oxygen. Okay, so first it forms a unipositive element. Second thing, it forms a water. Same, that is, it forms the oxides like hydrogen oxides forms, sulfide forms, halide forms, and also the peroxide formation. Okay, so and same way, if you take, it will be acting as a best reducing agent. So this character will determine that, okay. So this can be similar to the alkali metal. And one more point you should remember, okay. So if you take the ionization energy of alkali metals. Just if I give a comparison, alkali metals ionization energy, okay. So those are similarities, okay. So the hydrogen also forms oxide, like your alkali metal also forms oxide, the hydrogen also forms unipositive element, like it will be both similarities same. But in the form of ionization energy, we know that what is ionization energy? It is an energy used to remove an electron. Does used to remove electron from isolated atom, from a isolated atom. So it is a energy, okay, energy used to remove, okay. So this is a energy just we are going to supply, energy used to remove an electron from an isolated atom. So we know that ionization energy in the periodic table itself. Okay. So whatever may be depends upon the electron where it is present and how far from the nucleus. Okay. So ionization energy of alkali metal, if you take, the ionization energy it will be varies. Okay. So this ionization energy that will be varies for alkali metal. 377.2502, okay, kilocalories per mole. Okay, this energy difference. If you take a hydrogen, that is the ionization energy of a hydrogen, that is IE, ionization energy of hydrogen, if you take those energy value, this will be 1314, okay, kilocalories per mole. Okay, now you compare this two. So this is having something 300 to 500 only. Okay, but this ionization energy of hydrogen is high. This is having high. That is, ionization energy of hydrogen is high. So, what is the reason to have a high ionization energy of a hydrogen? We know that starting from the first class, okay. So, I gave a structure of an atom. So, in the structure of atom, what happened? Just I placed an electron in the first shell, correct? So, those electron in the first shell, if I place it, now what happened? So, the electron will be very close to the nucleus. So, the force of attraction between nucleus and the electron will be more. If you want to remove an electron, you have to spend more amount of the energy. That's why the ionization energy of the hydrogen is little bit higher compared with the alkali metal. So, this is the difference. Okay. So, ionization of alkali metal is less, ionization energy of hydrogen is water, high, this is less. Okay, It is clear? Next. Okay, so the ionization energy is less for alkali metal, but hydrogen is more. But we have discussed both properties are same. But this property is what? That can be, it is quite water, different from the alkali metal. Okay, and one more thing. This topic we are going to discuss the hydrogen position. Based on that, I am going to give a comparison one side alkali metal, one side the comparison with the halogen also. Now, alkali metal comparison over. Next, we can compare, okay, we can compare this with the halogen, okay, with the halogen. The halogen. Okay, next. With halogen. With halogen. Okay. Now, listen. So, we know that the halogen forms the halides. The halogen forms the halide. Like, for example, in generally, if I do X2 is what? Halogen. So, this can form a halide ion, that is X minus 2X minus, but how it is formed? The X2 la, if you add an electron, okay, if you add an electron, okay, that can be changes into what? X minus by taking one electron. This is called a halide ion. What ion? Halide ion. Halide ion. Okay. In a similar way, okay, the halide ion can be formed from the halogen. So, in a similar way, hydrogen also, if I take hydrogen, like for example, hydrogen, if I take H2, this hydrogen also has a tendency to form a hydride ion. But H minus is what? A hydride ion. Okay, hydride ion. But how this is possible? I can write this in different way. But both involving of a electron, both involvement of a electron. Okay. So now here I am adding only one electron. So I can write this H2 as half H2. It means what? Only one hydrogen atom. H, not H2. Half H2 is nothing but H. So this H is going to take one electron and it forms a hydride ion. So both halogen also forms a hex minus, and the hydrogen also forms a hydride ion. Both are similar, but while it forms a hydride ion, okay, this H minus, I'm going to compare with the noble gases, because what is this? If I take hydrogen, okay, this is the hydrogen, is nothing but consisting of a 1s1, only one electron in the shell. But what is the meaning of H minus? This is what? 1s2. It means the number of electron has increased, one electron added. So whenever in hydrogen, if you add one electron, the electronic configuration, it becomes 1s2. Okay, so it related to the noble gas configuration like helium. Okay, now the helium, the electronic configuration is 1s2. It forms a helium that related to the noble gas configuration. So why it forms like this? The H minus is taking a comparison of what? This electronic configuration of noble gases. From that we can take a difference between, okay, this halogen and also hydride ion. So if you take the electron affinity of hydrogen, can give a comparison. Electron affinity of hydrogen. We know that what is electron affinity? What is the electron affinity? So ionization energy is what? The energy required to remove the electron. The energy required to remove the electron. But here electron affinity means it is the amount of the energy that will be liberated. So if I take electron affinity, it is the amount of energy. Okay, it is the amount of energy liberated or released. Okay, released. It is the amount of energy liberated. Okay, when an atom takes an electron. Okay, amount of energy liberated when an atom takes an electron. Takes the electron. Now I am giving a comparison. Electron affinity of hydrogen is low. Why? What is the reason? It's low. What is the reason for this? Can I guess? Because we know that the electron affinity for hydrogen is low. The reason for this. Whenever the hydrogen, while it is accepting the electron, okay, the hydrogen, when it accepts an electron, it becomes what? Helium. It is acquiring the inner character. So helium has two electrons, it is completely filled. So if you take the helium, the nucleus will be center like this. Okay, and the first shell containing how many electrons? Only two electrons. Only two electrons like this. Okay, so over here, the electrons will be one, two. Okay, the first shell, how many electrons? We can put two electrons. So that is called completely filled. It is completely filled. Whether it is possible to take electron, it is already filled. It is not possible to take the electron. So that's why the electron affinity of a hydrogen is low in the case of a hydride ion. That is one discussion. Okay. So when we take, this is a comparison, I will give you one more equation of indicating this Br2. That is, if we take a halide ion, Br2, okay, if it takes electron, this becomes Br-. Okay, now I can write half Br2, that is nothing but Br. So Br taking one electron becomes Br-. This energy released, that is the energy I can give you, plus 36 kilocalories per mole. Same way, if you take a hydrogen, so H2 plus, okay, acquiring one electron becomes H-. This is nothing but half H2. It means what? Only one hydrogen. Okay. So this adding minus 55 kilocalories per mole. The energy difference is so high. Okay. This is called the energy difference between these two chemical reactions. Okay. So whenever if they ask you what is the ionization energy of a hydrogen, will be always ion compared with the alkali metal. Okay. But what is the electron affinity of hydrogen? The electron affinity of hydrogen is low compared with the halide ion. Why means the whenever the hydrogen atom is, takes one electron, becomes a water, noble gas electronic configuration. So that's why the electron affinity of a hydrogen is low. Okay, next. So just I'm giving a conclusion where it is located. Okay. So on seeing this property, whether ionization energy and the electron affinity. Okay, so we come to one conclusion that similarities between alkali metal and the halogen. Alkali metal and the halogen. Now, if you take hydrogen, the hydrogen exists. Okay, in all its compound, that the valency of the hydrogen, okay, the oxidation state of a hydrogen. Hydrogen oxidation stage. Okay, in all the compounds plus one. But in hydrides alone, only minus. Hydrides. Just it is minus 1. Okay, hydrides, it is just what? Minus 1. Hydrides. Okay, minus 1. So, in all the compound, I present existing oxidation state of plus 1. Okay, because of this nature, so finally we come to the conclusion. We can place a hydrogen over that alkali metal at the left side of the periodic table. We know that even though the hydrogen is a non-metal, but we are placing only into the metal side. So that's the reason for this is, even though it is a non-metal, but the character is more or less similarities with the or resemblance with the alkali metal. That's why we are placing the hydrogen in the left side. Okay. So now it is clear. Question is clear. Okay. Next, we can go with the isotopes of a hydrogen. Next, we can take the isotopes of a hydrogen. Okay. If I take the isotopes of a hydrogen, we know that the hydrogen existing in the three forms. We know that. Okay. What is isotope system? Already we know. If an element existing of a same atomic number but different mass number. The elements are same. Okay. But the atomic number is same. But mass number is different means that is called an isotope. Now let me give. There are three types of a hydrogen, that is isotopes of a hydrogen. Okay, there are three types. First one is protium. And second one is deuterium. Okay, And third one is tritium. Okay, now I'll give you what is this and that. Protium is hydrogen, all made up of hydrogen only, but atomic number and mass number of H11. The protium H11, what it means? Number of proton is 1, number of electron is 1. I can see the picture for protium. Center, okay, you take one proton. Okay, this is one proton. Okay, and the first shell consisting of how many electrons? Only one. Like this. Okay, now if you take a deuterium, that is deuterium, H12. Here, number of proton is 1, number of neutron is 1. Number of electron also 1, because if I take this is your nucleus, okay, you assume that it's a nucleus, it consisting of a nucleus is made up of a protons and neutrons only. One proton and one neutron. This is made up of nucleus is made up of one proton and one neutron. Now your electron showing like this, electron also 1. There is no change in the electron, but here you know that indicating a one neutron excess. Okay, the same way if you take tritium, H13. So, what it means, okay, here the proton is going on increasing. Okay, so the protons and the neutrons, okay, and the electrons also what are going on increasing. Likewise, only you should remember that the number of protons and the number of neutrons, it is going on increasing. Okay, so now if you take protium and also deuterium, deuterium is what? H12 and tritium H13. Okay, so if you take the structure of our tritium, it consisting of what? One proton. Okay, so proton is what? Same that, and also one neutrons also possible. So one proton and a two neutrons. So if you take that, the electrons will be different. So I can draw the structure like this, that is of indicating the nucleus. Okay, so if you take that, okay, one proton, okay, two neutron like this, and one electron like this. Okay, so there will be difference because all protium, deuterium, and tritium we took. The protium, we have only one atomic number. So protium atomic number is only one. Only one. Tritium also atomic number same. Deuterium also atomic number same. But there will be difference in the mass number. So protium mass number one, deuterium mass number two, and tritium mass number three. Okay, and if you take the protein, the occurrence of the protein. So here, the protein predominantly occurs. That is 99.98% should be your protein. So more or less, what predominant occurrence will be your protein. If you take a tritium, so it will be 0.015% only your deuterium. Okay, and if you take a tritium, it is present only in tracer amount, only very little amount only it is occur. Okay, and this normally of this character, the normal hydrogen we can write, the normal hydrogen we can replace like this. We can write HT, that is deuterated hydrogen, tritium, that is D. Like this we can write. Okay. So if you write deuterium as D, tritium as T. Okay. So for this purpose, we can replace HT, HD like that. Okay. So the isotopes of hydrogen, there are three types of hydrogen. We have discussed isotope. One is protium, deuterium, and tritium. Okay. So now next year, we can move with the properties. Okay, so if you compare this protium, deuterium, and tritium, the boiling point and the melting points. Okay, so if you take protium, generally the protium, the boiling point and melting point, the protium is greater, melting point, and also next comes to the deuterium, and next last one will be tritium. So if you write this order, the melting point and the boiling point of comparison between protium, deuterium, and tritium. Okay, the boiling point and melting point, it is higher for only protium. Okay, this is a physical properties comparison. Now, if you take next topic, how can you differentiate between, that is, ortho and para hydrogen? Ortho and para hydrogen. Okay, now what is ortho and para hydrogen? Okay, so first of all, if you take a hydrogen, so not taking of only one hydrogen, when the molecule is formed, that is a molecule hydrogen. You take a molecule formation of hydrogen, when the molecule is formed, we can expect two types of a hydrogen. The molecules forms means we can form a two type of a hydrogen. One is ortho hydrogen and another one is para hydrogen. Now, what is this ortho and para? Okay, now hydrogen is molecule is made up of how many atoms of hydrogen? Two. I can write one hydrogen atom as well. This one hydrogen atom. And another one hydrogen atom. Okay, this is a molecule formation. Now, if you take that, the spin of the nuclei of a hydrogen, that is, what is spin of a nuclei of hydrogen? Spin of nuclei of hydrogen. We know what is spin. Direction, spinning of an electron. We know all quantum numbers. That we discussed spin quantum number. What is the meaning of spin quantum number? Which direction the electrons movement is spin of a nuclei of a hydrogen. So for this pair hydrogen molecule, the spin of the hydrogen molecule, first one hydrogen spin will be in this direction. This is clockwise direction. And same way, the second hydrogen atom also spin in the same direction. Same direction. This is called the, that is, the spins of a nuclei of hydrogen in the same direction. In same direction. This is called the orthohydrogen. What is called the orthohydrogen? Ortho form. The spin of a nuclei of a hydrogen, both are in the same direction, means we will get an ortho form. Same way I can show you the para form also. Okay, so for the para form, if I take one hydrogen like this, one hydrogen atom, this is one hydrogen atom. This is the second hydrogen atom. Okay, now what about the spin? If you take one hydrogen atom, will spin in clockwise direction. Spin in clockwise, that is in one direction. The spin of the another hydrogen atom, that is in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so what is para form means? That is the spin of nuclei of hydrogen. Spin of nuclei of hydrogen. Of hydrogen in different direction. Same means ortho, different means it is a para. That is only a difference. It is a para form. Okay, now you know what is ortho form and para form. The spin of a nuclei of hydrogen in the same direction means we will get an ortho form. The spin of a nuclei of hydrogen in different direction means we will get a para form. Okay, now we will discuss about this properties of ortho and the para form. We will discuss about the ortho and the para form. Okay, we will discuss about the properties of ortho and para form. Okay, now if it is, you know what is ortho form? The spin of a nuclei. Spin of the nuclei of hydrogen is same. Okay, spin of a nuclei of hydrogen is same. We will get about the ortho form. If the spin of a nuclei are different, we will get a para. Okay, so now we will discuss about the properties of this ortho and the para form. Okay, so like this, if you take the properties, okay, if you take that at normal temperature, okay, at normal form, okay, normal temperature, okay, if you take at normal temperature, for a hydrogen, okay, normal hydrogen if you take, the 75%, okay, that is, totally we know that 100%, okay, in that, 75% will be in one form, that is, if you take ortho and the para form, both will not existing in the same amount, that is, one form is different from the another form. Okay, so if you take that the percentage of those ortho and para form, 75% will be your ortho form. Okay, and 25% remaining will be your para form. But if you take this 75% ortho, the ortho only more stable. Okay, more stable compared with the para. Compared with what? para. So ortho form only more stable because the percentage of occurrence is more, 75%. So because of this getting stability. Okay. Now the conversion of a ortho form into para form, that is ortho we are going to convert into para form. Okay, para form. So conversion of ortho into para form, it is a slow process. Slow process. But we are not converting, but there is a conversion possibility, but the process is taking in very, very slow manner. How can we convert this ortho form into para form? Okay, at the equilibrium. So at the equilibrium, there is a chance of reaching of para isomer possible. The condition is that you have to lower the temperature. Okay, the condition is you have to lower the temperature. Okay, so when you when you decrease the temperature, there is a possible of converting the ortho isomer into para isomer, one possibility. And the same way, we can convert the ortho into para isomer by using of a process also. Okay, we know that catalytical reaction, by catalytically means by using of hydrogen, platinum, palladium, like that, we can convert ortho into para isomer. Or some other process also we can use, that is mixed with the, that is converting of ortho and para isomer. We can mix with the nascent hydrogen. What is the meaning of nascent? Means atomic hydrogen. Nascent means atomic hydrogen. Okay. Mixed with the paramagnetic substance. Mixed with the paramagnetic substance. Paramagnetic substance. Or by passing electric discharge. When you pass electric current, there is a chance of water converting ortho isomer into para isomer, heating above 800 degrees Celsius. Heating above 800 degrees Celsius. So these are all the four points we should remember. Okay, that is mixed with the nascent hydrogen, mixed with the paramagnetic substance. You know what is the meaning of paramagnetic substance? Consisting of an unpaired electron substance and passing electric discharge, passing electric current, heating the ortho isomer over about 800 degrees Celsius, there is a chance of converting ortho isomer to ortho to para form. Okay, these are all the four processes we can adopt to convert ortho into para. Okay, and next, if you take the comparison of this ortho and para, okay, what is the boiling point and the melting point comparison? Okay, so if I take boiling point and the melting point of ortho and para form, okay, if you take the melting point, melting point, para form, okay, and ortho form, if you take. So this melting point of para form is, okay, 13.86 degrees Celsius, 13.86. But comparing ortho form, this will be 13.95. That is degree Celsius only we require, melting point. Same way, if you compare the boiling point of para form, okay, the boiling point is, the para form is 20.26 degree Celsius, and the same way comparing ortho form, 20.39 degree Celsius. Okay, now if you take the comparison of ortho and the para form, melting point and the boiling point, we come to know that one difference, slight difference. The melting point of the paraform is less compared with the orthoform. And same way, the boiling point of the paraform also less compared with the orthoform. We know that the orthoform is occurring in how much percentage? Only 75%. That is only more stable. Because of that only, the melting point of orthoform and boiling point of the orthoform is much higher. Okay. And next, we are going to discuss about the magnetic moment. Okay. So, if you take orthohydrogen and parahydrogen, magnetic moment. If you take a magnetic moment, the orthoform, okay, the orthoform, magnetic moment, orthoform. Magnetic moment, ortho and para form. Okay. If you take ortho, the spin of the nuclei of a hydrogen, two hydrogen are in the same direction. Same direction means we will get a magnetic moment, and that magnetic moment value is twice of normal hydrogen, twice of hydrogen. So, when you compare hydrogen magnetic moment, okay, that magnetic moment of hydrogen, okay, if you compare with the orthohydrogen, twice time what is greater compared with the ordinary hydrogen. If you take a para, so what is the meaning of para? The spin of a nuclei of a two hydrogen are different. Let me show the figure. Okay, so here, the ortho and the para hydrogen, you can see. Yeah, what spin of nuclei of hydrogen, orthoform is what? Same direction. Same direction means you will get a magnetic moment two times greater than the normal hydrogen. If you take a para form, okay, the spin of the nuclei of one hydrogen in one direction and another hydrogen in another direction. So here, yeah, the spin of this will be cancelled. Okay, will be what? Yeah, cancelled. And when you calculate the magnetic moment of the paraform, that is paraform is zero. If you compare the magnetic moment of the paraform is what? Zero. So they may ask one word question. That is the magnetic moment of ortho, whether it is zero or para is zero. Sometimes they may ask like that question. And what about the comparison between melting point and boiling point also they may ask, because whenever they are comparing ortho and para, slightly different only, but more or less what it is greater compared with the ortho form and the para form. Ortho is greater. So like that, you may have a different type of questions. Okay, now let us see. Let us go through one time. Okay, all the pages and give you direct 1 word, 2 marks, like 5 marks questions, no? The discussion point also. Okay. So first, we have seen about hydrogen, no, character. So hydrogen, just we have taken that hydrogen is consisting of a smallest element. Okay, smallest element. In that, they may give a question like that. Okay. So, being a smallest element, okay, and also consisting of an unpaired electron, and also the character of more reactive and existing of a diatomic molecule, more reactive diatomic molecule, unpaired electron. Okay, the hydrogen is differ from the rest of the element. So, which character differs the hydrogen from the rest of the element means? You should remember all those things. Okay. And same way, if you take the occurrence, okay, so they may occur in the form of water, carbohydrates, and the proteins. Okay. If you take the position of a hydrogen, okay, if you take the position of the hydrogen, they may ask the position of hydrogen in the 2 mark question. Or sometimes, if they are asking as a 1 mark question, we should able to know that. Okay, how will you give the position of a hydrogen? Okay, so you should remember, okay, there is a comparison, position of a hydrogen. But even though we are locating the hydrogen in the left side corner above that alkali metal, what is the reason for that? So So if you look at the electronic configuration, the valence and electronic configuration of a hydrogen 1s1 and also the alkali metal ns1. So both this character resembles the hydrogen and the alkali metals are same. And one more property also we are going to discuss about uniparticle element. Okay? So if you take a hydrogen and also the alkali metal, both are forming a uniparticle element. And the same way it forms a oxides. It forms a oxides related to the alkali metal. So that's why just comparison with the halide also the predominant character given to the alkali metal. So that's why we are placing left side corner of that alkali metal. So above that we are placing a hydrogen. Okay, and we have discussed about ionization energy. In that we will get one more question. So ionization energy of hydrogen is what? More compared with the alkali metal. Okay, so ionization energy of hydrogen is more. 1314. So we'll get this is also on third question. Okay, and same way, how can you compare the hydrogen with the halogen? That is also one more question. So if you compare the hydrogen with the halogen, both are forming what? Halide ion and the hydride. Both are requiring an electron, accepting electron. It forms a halide ion and a hydride ion. But there is one comparison. Electron affinity of hydrogen is low here. Electron affinity of hydrogen is low here. So why means low? Because it is hydride ion. After that getting of one electron, the hydrogen becomes a hydride ion. The electronic configuration, it is related to the helium. So helium, you know, it is a noble gas. More that is unreactive element. So because of that fully filled electronic configuration, it is not possible to take one more electron. So that's why electron affinity of a hydrogen is low. So we discussed this is a one more question. And the same way the energy released also. And one more, the oxidation state of a hydrogen. The oxidation state of a hydrogen in all its element, it's showing +1. This is a one more question. But exception is hydrides, because in hydrides -1. Okay, hydrides -1. And because this character only, it is resemblance with the alkali metals. Okay. And next we discuss about the isotope. Isotopes of a hydrogen, there are three types: protium, deuterium, and tritium. And where I have given that how many protons, how many neutrons, like, and giving a comparison, the occurrence. So basically, what a protium is predominant, correct? 99.985, and remaining only less. Okay. And finally, we discussed about the types ortho and para-hydrogen. We know that ortho-hydrogen means what we are discussing about. When the molecule has formed only, there are what two hydrogen atoms. The spin of a nuclei of a hydrogen atom or same means will get an ortho form. The spin of a hydrogen is different means will get a para form. And if the comparison at normal temperature, 75% only occurrence ortho form, that will be more stable compared with the para form. But is it possible to convert ortho into para means? Yes, of course possible, but the process is very, very small. But in between ortho and para, there is existing, always existing of a equilibrium. You know that what is equilibrium? We can shift ortho form into para form or para form into ortho form. And there is a condition at the equilibrium when we lower the temperature only, we can possible to convert the ortho into para form. Okay, some other process also we can adapt by using of nascent hydrogen, mixing with the paramagnetic substance, passing electric current, and heating above 18 degrees Celsius also, we can convert ortho form into para form. And there is a conversion, melting point comparison, and then finally, I conclude with the magnetic movement. Magnetic movement of para isomer is zero. That is a one word question. Okay, so possible questions they may ask. Discuss the question in the periodic table of hydrogen. What are the three possible isotopes of hydrogen? Discuss about the isotope of hydrogen. How can you give a comparison of a hydrogen with the alkali metal? One question. How can you give a comparison hydrogen with the halogen? One question. And same way, what are ortho hydrogen? What are para hydrogen? Discuss about the properties of ortho and para hydrogen. One question. And one more question, which is more stable, which has magnetic movement, and what is spin of those ortho and para from they may ask. Okay, so this are the possible questions. Okay, so now if you have any doubt, you can share your doubt with me. Okay. Students, can you hear me now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yes,
ma'am.
Do you have any doubt that I present lesson topic question in the already we have discussed, but the position and the types is quite different. That's why I didn't have any doubt in that area.
No, ma'am.
No doubt, ma'am.
No doubt. No one has doubt. Will you able to follow this chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, this is doubt only. You can ask doubts. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Are you able to follow?
Yes.
Okay, okay, students. You go through that. This I have given the possible type of questions also regarding your weak point and as for the theory point, I have given the 2-mark pattern, 5-mark pattern, 1-mark pattern like that. You go through that. If you have any doubt, tomorrow also I'm going to continue this chapter. If you have any doubt, that section you can ask. Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Okay,
ma'am.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, 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 ma'am.